Master, Master, let me do it.
Come on, Bruno. I'm sure the bucket is bigger than you are. How are you going to be able to get it up here full of water? Don't be childish.
I'm not a child. Let me do it. Help, Master. Help me. Please.
I warned you. You're much too impulsive. You deserve it.
I only wanted to help, Master.
It's enough when you don't touch a thing and speak only when I tell you to. That's all the help I need from you. I hope your interlude in the well helps you spend some thought on that.
What? Do you intend to leave me down here?
Only as long as necessary, Bruno.
But... Master...
Is the water drinkable?
I don't know. I didn't have enough time to... Don't laugh, Master. Get me out of here.
Can you climb out by yourself?
If I could, I would have done it already. I need your help.
Do you have any idea how I can get you out of the well?
Quickly, if that's possible. Otherwise, I'll catch cold.
I'll find a way to get you out. Stay right there.
What does that mean? Stay right there. Where shall I go? As a pilgrim on St. James's Way.
Can you hear me, Bruno?
Yes. The acoustics down here are fabulous.
Listen very closely. I'm going to let a rope down. Hold on to it tightly if you can. And don't forget to bring the bucket up with you. Did you understand me?
Yes. Hurry, please.
Good. It's on the way.
Thank you, Master.
Bruno.
Yes?
What about the bucket?
Please don't be angry with me.
I knew this was going to happen. Oh, what's the point? It can't be helped. Come on. You can't very well walk around here dripping wet. We'll go to the cell to dry you off.
I've already changed clothes, Master.
He just keeps dripping and dripping. Everything's going to get wet. Bruno has already changed clothes.
What are you doing, Master?
I'm getting water from the well. What you were supposed to do. Brother Marcello is the illustrious librarian and eminent guardian of the rules. Brother.
Yes?
Can't you make an exception for me?
That would be unpermissible. It would be against the rules. I'm sorry, brother, but I believe I put it clearly.
Ah, a copyist. Remember how you had me write down? I must use my brain to think once. I had to write it down 100 times.
Tell me, Brother Marcello, what requirements must my novice fulfill to be accepted as an apprentice copyist?
Your novice? Are you talking about this novice?
Yes, he belongs to your order. Indeed, that's the very reason his father, the Count of Capra Negra, entrusted him to me. His dream is to become a magnificent copyist at the Abbey. Isn't that right, Bruno? Isn't that right, Bruno?
Huh. Yes.
Well,
there's no rule that prohibits an apprentice from being allowed to enter the second floor, is there?
True! There isn't.
Fabulous, brother. He's going to become an accomplished copyist. Tell me, please, what does my novice need in order to be accepted as an apprentice copyist?
Well then, he has to copy a page from a book. The first page of Hortus Tuus. Naturally, the copy must be a translation into Latin, because the original was written in Greek.
Hortus Tuus, you say?
It's a work about botany, a tract on medicinal plants.
That's a good title. Where can I get that book?
Speak with Godfrey, my assistant. He'll get it for you.
Master, am I really going to become a copyist?
It would be better for you if you did, because if you don't make the grade, we'll never be let into the scriptorium.
I'm going to become the best copyist in our order. I'll be greater than Betus de Labana. People are going to cry when they look at my miniatures.
Oh yes, cry they will, Bruno. I don't doubt that.
What do you mean by that?
Forget it. May I ask you a few questions about Anselmo?
I know what the abbot has given you to do. You can ask what you like about Anselmo.
What do you think about Anselmo? Do you have to think about that, brother?
Yes. I wanted to describe Anselmo in a single sentence, but I think it's impossible for me to do it.
I don't understand you.
Look, brother, I don't know if you know this. Perhaps you've already spoken about Anselmo with someone else from the Abbey. Doesn't matter. I'd swear on a stack of Bibles that all of them are going to tell you about his inacceptable arrogance.
What is that supposed to mean? Inacceptable.
All right. Perhaps I went too far when I described his attitude as inacceptable, but a bit of modesty would have gotten him more respect from the other brothers.
How did the attitude you're referring to manifest itself?
Oh, that! He boasted about how well-read he was. Oh, yes, he always corrected other brothers when they pronounced something wrong, or he reproached them sharply when they didn't know something like a psalm or a historical detail. Oh, do you know what I mean?
Very well.
I don't believe that his intentions were completely wrong. Not everyone here has the same level of education. You'll grasp that when you speak with Egidio, for example. As I said, the reprehensible thing wasn't his intention. It was the way he behaved. On the other hand, he visited the library often. He constantly tried to increase his knowledge. That's to his credit. It would be nice if the common folk had the same thirst for knowledge.
If he were perhaps granted access to the library.
What? Are you joking?
The abbot implied that Anselmo's death could have been something other than a coincidence.
He said that to me. Indeed he did.
And what's your opinion about that?
I don't know what I should say. I don't believe that one of our brothers would deliberately be out to kill a fellow brother.
That makes sense. It would be against the rules.
Yes, against all the rules. That's the point. I presume that the abbot has also mentioned something to you that you shouldn't take lightly.
Are you referring to the idea that the devil feels at home in the Abbey?
This is a serious topic, brother. We all know that evil has been wreaking havoc all over this unfortunate world since time began. But of all places, why here, at this humble abbey?
Evil does not distinguish between one place and the next.
Oh, that's certainly true. But if so many wars, attacks, lootings, and rapes are taking place outside, isn't it logical that he would prefer terrain like that, and not within these walls?
A good theory.
To be honest, yet without wanting to contradict the abbot, I must tell you that I do not share his opinion.
If that's the case, what do you think about Anselmo's death?
I don't know what I should think, but it's not my task to root around in such matters. I serve our Lord by looking after the library.
What kind of material did Anselmo usually look for in the library?
Anything he could make use of. Oh, his thirst for knowledge knows no bounds. Despite his work as a gatekeeper, he constantly came to the library to study manuscripts.
Without a doubt, he was trying to undermine the hierarchy at the Abbey. Did he ask for particular titles?
No, I don't remember any particular one, though once.
Yes?
I can't recall exactly what subject it dealt with, but it still strikes me that I had to refuse his request.
Why?
How should I put it? Some books are not allowed to be lent out. That's why access to the library archives is limited to Gottfried and me.
How did Anselmo react to the refusal?
I don't remember any more. I suppose he attached the same importance to the subject that I did. Namely, none at all. I presume he simply asked out of curiosity.
We should let Anselmo rest in peace, brother. Would you be able to give me some information about the library?
As you like.
To which works does the library owe its fame?
The library's fame basically stems not only from the work our copyists do, but also from our zeal towards collecting, archiving, and publishing a large number of books. As far as I know, you won't be able to set your eyes on a collection like this at any other abbey.
Are there really that many?
Thousands of them!
I'm impressed. Tell me something about your work.
The post carries a lot of responsibility. As you can imagine, in an abbey like this, it's one of the most important jobs. It requires a great deal of dedication and hard work to get to be a librarian. And once you get there, it means investing even more time and effort. You have to archive, catalog, restore, preserve.
I get the point. Do you like it?
Of course I do. Alongside the love of our Lord, the reading matters and studies are the two reasons I get up each day, ready to forge ahead. Ooh, I love being surrounded by books, the smell of ink, and of my brother copyists, who know how to value the significance of simply bound pages. I love this work.
Tell me something about the library archives.
I assume you're not only talking about the books that can be accessed freely.
Indeed, I'm not. The abbot made a remark that some books are not accessible.
Some books? Hundreds of them!
And why is it not allowed to consult those books?
Our library holds ancient and unique, as well as particularly precious works of art that might be damaged by wrongful use. It is our duty to preserve these precious works and take good care of them.
But isn't it a shame to keep them shut away like this? Wouldn't it be a noble gesture to make them accessible?
That is forbidden by the rules.
There seems doubtless every reason to be grateful for your endeavors in preserving art and objects of cultural value. I'm sure I could appreciate your efforts even more if I were granted permission to view some of those works with my own eyes.
Do not let that be of any concern to you, Brother Leonardo. We have countless further freely accessible works that will most assuredly satisfy you.
But how am I to browse those works if you deny me access to the library upstairs?
My assistant and I have access. Simply choose a tome from the index and ask Gottfried to get it for you.
Where can the index be consulted?
Well, go to the lower floor and head down the stairs to the tall archway.
Yes, yes, I get the point. I think I've gotten the information I wanted. Thank you kindly, brother.